evening. I'm so glad that you're here. I know that it's a really busy season. Lots of these guys just came from basketball games, and supporting your kids and making sure that they're here and being in the audience to support them as well. This is our second concert this year for the middle school, the 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. We performed three pieces in the pep rally in November, and so we spent the beginning of the year sort of getting back into playing again, and then we learned those pieces, and now we had a month to prepare for this concert, so we're excited to show you what we've been doing in class so far. This concert's a little bit different than some of our previous winter concerts. The 7th and 8th graders this year are going to go to a band competition in April, and so the project that we normally do in January and February, I pushed until this concert. So you'll see in your program that there are some small ensemble performances, and that's a project that we normally do when we have lots of snow days, and it doesn't matter how the schedule works out as much. So we decided to put that into this month to play for you this evening, and then that gives us an opportunity to really make sure we're prepared and learning our music for our competition in April. Also, 7th and 8th grade parents, I'm going to send you more information about the competition later. there's a program note that I have a typo in the program. You'll see under the 7th grade small ensembles that it says that two groups are playing a piece called Floral Fury, and that's not true. The second piece that's listed there that says it's by the Eagles is actually Hotel California, which is by the Eagles, so that was a typo. Please take a moment now to silence your cell phone. Mine's in airplane mode, so that it doesn't go off while the students are performing and we can really be present in the moment. One of the great things about band concerts and other live performances you go to is that you get to experience music live. So often in our lives, we experience it through recorded everything, phone ringers and listening to it on our earbuds and in the car, and on television and movies and on our computer. And so this is not digital music, this is acoustic. This is going to be live music that you're hearing, and there's nothing in between. So it's a really great opportunity to really physically experience music tonight. And so our first group is the 5th grade band. Here is Lauren and Hayden to introduce our first song.
Hello, my name is Lauren Geddes, and I play the clarinet.
My name is Hayden Pittler, and I play the alto saxophone.
This is our first year in band at McDonogh. Our class has been playing for 2 months, and we have had a lot to learn to start. We started with learning how to put our instruments together, hold them, and how to make a sound. After that, we learned how to read music, and we had to learn how to read different rhythms in our songs, as well as the notes on our staff. Our first piece for you tonight is called Pharma, and will be played by the woodwind section. Enjoy!
By the ocean. This song has primarily quarter notes and half notes, which are notes that are one and two beats long.
An important part about playing in band is keeping a steady beat, not just as individuals performing.
but also as a group so that we can play together. We have been working on listening to each other so that we can stay together. Please enjoy the area.
Instead of a really loud noise or a squeak.
For percussion, we didn't have to work on how to blow into our instrument. Instead, we have been working on how to control the drumsticks as we play. For example, I have to squeeze my sticks while I play to be able to make the drum roll sound. Mallets are different. We have to learn where the notes are on the bells by recognizing the patterns of the bars. Each instrument has its own set of things to learn to be played correctly.
Our next song will be played by both class sections, and it is called Sweetly Sings the Donkey.
Concentration, but we're doing it really well. Enjoy Jingle Bells!
Thank you. Will Aitz, and I play the trumpet. The first eighth grade piece we will play for you is a Christmas mashup that combines Carol of the Bells and We Three Kings. The lilting melody line of Carol of the Bells fits really well with the steady melody of We Three Kings. Please.
My name is Drew Marson, and I play percussion.
My name is Ryan Heljevich, and I play the alto saxophone.
The next few pieces this evening are shorter pieces being performed by small ensembles from our class. Each group selected their song and had to arrange it for the instruments in their group, balancing out the melody and harmony parts, and then put it together.
Our first small ensemble performance tonight is a piece called Floral Fury, and it is the theme song from the video game Cuphead, which is inspired by 1930s cartoons. It has many challenging rhythms and is very upbeat. Here is Floral Fury.
Thank you. My name is Faye Tiefen, and I play the trumpet. Our next piece is called Drowning by A Boogie, and is a hip-hop song that we have translated for band instruments. This group enjoys hip-hop music and found a piece that had a good rap melody to be played on the instruments. Here is Drowning.
My name is Vincent Chang, and I play the bass clarinet. The last 8th grade small ensemble group will be performing Hotel California by the Eagles. We had to figure out how to translate the guitar parts for our band instruments and put it all together. It took some work, and we hope you enjoy Hotel California.
One of the reasons why we did this project is to give the students an opportunity to learn about the parts of music outside of a classroom setting. As many of you parents know, when they play their band music at home, it doesn't always sound like a song because it's just one small piece. So when we do this project, they're talking about melody, they're talking about harmony, how do you put it together, and then they have to learn how to rehearse on their own. Because music isn't obviously just happening in our classrooms, and so this gives them an opportunity to experience and learn some of the skills that they would need if they want to do music and create music on their own in their own settings. At this time, I would like to invite the seventh graders up. We're going to do the picture first, and then they will continue playing for you.
My name is Brocking, and then I play. My name is Brock Gagan, and I play bass. The next three pieces on our concert tonight are the small ensemble songs performed by the 7th grade band students. For this project, we could either pick a Beatles song to learn as a group or write our own piece. The first group will play their rendition of Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles.
Thank you. is Anil Mabucha, and I play the alto saxophone. The next piece on the concert is called The Escape, and it is an original composition written by us. We worked collaboratively to compose this piece for this project. We are excited to present The Escape. Please enjoy.
At this time, I would like to invite the sixth graders up, and we will get ready to play our last piece for you this evening. While they're coming on stage quietly, as quiet as middle schoolers can be, I wanted to say a couple of things. Of course, I'm going to really get them to be quiet. There's so many people that have made this evening possible. All of the work that's gone into it is mostly in part because of the work that these students have done. You've heard them at home. Hopefully you've heard them at home. And I'm so proud of them and everything that they've done. As you can tell, we have a lot going on in the middle school band room. And there's a lot of opportunities to learn different things, try things, mess up, try again. I make mistakes all the time, as you can see in your program. Also, my name's not even in there, all sorts of typos. And so, it's a good opportunity for them to see that it's okay to make a mistake. It happens all the time. And that what we do is we just keep going. So, some of the other people that are in part responsible for making this evening a success are the tech people in the booth. So, Bill, Tyler, and Sue make it look beautiful. Thank you so much to them. Administration, Darren and Jennifer, to Don and Susie and Mike and all the other music teachers and arts faculty, to Charlie. This is a really wonderful place to teach as a teacher. There's so much support, there's so much going on for all of your students, as you know, because your kids are in all of it and you have to drive them there. So I'm so grateful to the faculty and to the administration for the opportunity that I have to teach here. And I want to say a thank you to you as parents. You choose to send your children here. You choose and you make the sacrifices to be a part of this community, but this community is what it is because you're making that choice. So it's this cycle that goes on. And you don't get to see it every day in the ways that we do here at school, in the classrooms, during advisory, in lunch and on the playgrounds and in the hallways. I get to hear students being kind to one another, learning about that process, learning about who they are, and exploring things, trying new things, and it's really amazing to be a part of that, to help sort of guide them when they forget to try those things. And that's because of you guys as the parents. So I want to extend my gratitude to you and let you know that your choice is making a difference. And I know middle school is a busy time with a lot going on, but you have some really incredible kids here. Can we give a round of applause for them? I also wanted to just give one more round of applause to all of the 7th and 8th graders that played, because they were all basically doing solos. And most of them have never done a solo before, and it's super nerve-wracking. So can just to all the 7th and 8th graders who did that, can you give them a round of applause? Our last piece this evening, we're about to play that for you, and then after that we have a reception, which is hosted by the parents. Thank you so much for coming this evening. Please join us for a reception in the lobby afterwards. And this is Liku and Jay, who will introduce our last piece.
My name is Niku Nasiri, and I play the piano.
My name is Jay Josh, and I play the alto saxophone.
The last piece on the concert tonight is called Joyful and Triumphant, and is a Christmas fanfare based on the carol, O Come All Ye Faithful. This is an old hymn that was written around 1740 and is still popular today.
All the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade band students are performing together for this piece. Typically, concert bands have large numbers and can play with a big full sound. By having us all play together, we will be able to create that type of sound for our final piece. Please enjoy Joyful and Triumphant.